What is going on, good people of YouTube? It is me, Chavez, back with a Prizepicks video for you. We're talking the NFL Championship Weekend. Bengals, Chiefs, 49ers, Eagles. Should be a great weekend. Should be a great sports weekend in general. NBA, NFL, college basketball. Gotta love it. Got to love it. Listen, I wanted to talk a little bit about this Joe Burrow Free Square. If you are unfamiliar to Prizepicks, then let me preview you to this free square thing. So basically what Prizepicks likes to do from time to time is throw one of these insanely, obviously hit the over type of props. And this one happens to be Joe Burrow, 0.5 passing yards. We've seen it in the past with Tom Brady. We've seen it in the NBA. I think Luka had a 0.5 point prop. So this is a 0.5 passing yards prop for Joe Burrow. He needs to throw for 1 yard to hit this. Now, you cannot play this by itself. You must pair it with at least one other person, and it cannot be somebody from his own team. So eliminate all his pass catchers. Can't play him with Jamar Chase or Hayden Hurst or T. Higgins. So what I want to do in this video is try to figure out the best play to pair with Joe Burrow, because I would like to run this in a two-man power, because the odds of hitting a two-man power play are greater than you hitting a five-man flex or six-man flex. And I believe this play is playable up to $25. So if you two-man flex it, that's three times your money. That's $75. So I'm right now, as of making this video, I'm leaning Brock Purdy under on pass attempts. Brock Purdy has been taking the NFL by storm. He is just like the best story ever, right? Mr. Irrelevant. I mean, you can't write a better script for this kid, right? But he's not Joe Burrow. He's not Patrick Mahomes. He's not going out there and, you know, throwing it 40 times a game, 35 times a game. You can see here over the last five games, inclusive of his last two playoff starts, he has not hit 31. He got close, but in player props, close isn't good enough. You don't get points for close. So I do like his chances of going under on this one. As of now, this probably is my favorite choice to pair with Joe Burrow. But another one that I was thinking about and just, you know, and I'm not completely sold on it, but another one that I was just considering is the combined passing yards for both Brock Purdy and Jalen Hurts, or the combined passing yards for Joe Burrow and Patrick Mahomes. Like, am I crazy? But actually, never mind this one, because we can't play Joe Burrow twice. So yeah, it has to be Brock Purdy and Jalen Hurts if you wanted to go combined passing yards. I mean, 242 passing yards, 215 passing yards. I mean, that's 459 passing yards. To go less on this one, that's what I'm kind of leaning. And here's my reason why. Like, Brock Purdy has passed for, you know, a considerable amount of yards over the last five games, right? 234, 284, 332 against Seattle. But he has not faced a defense like this Philly defense. And I just don't see him passing for a lot of yards in this game. And, you know, I don't think the 49ers win this game on the arm of Brock Purdy. I think they have to run the ball. I really, really do. I think they have to mix it up with Deebo Samuel, mix up the play calling. They win this game because Brock Purdy is making good decisions and he's efficient and he's not making, you know, he's not throwing interceptions. They're not winning it if Brock Purdy has to throw this ball 40 times a game, 40 times in this game. I don't think they are. When I look at the other side and look at Jalen Hurts and see his passing total at 242, I ask myself, will he need to throw for 242 yards in this game? Will he need to throw for 243 yards in this game? Can the Eagles win with Jalen Hurts going under this? And I think they can, because they did it last week. That game was well in hand by halftime. Obviously, the 49ers are a much better team than the Giants, but I just can't see them putting Jalen Hurts in a position to re-injure his shoulder or to hurt himself anymore if they don't have to. A Super Bowl berth is on the line. If they can win this game with Jalen Hurts passing for 200 yards and rushing for 50 or 60 yards, I'm pretty sure the Philadelphia fan base wouldn't be mad. So, I don't know, man. I'm looking at this passing yards prop, and I'm tempted to play the under. It's playoff football. Playoff football is much different than regular season football, especially when you're not, you know, going out there trying to get the number one seed. It's already locked up. They're already in the playoffs. They're already the number one seed. They're hosting the NFC Championship. All they have to do is go out there and win. They don't have to do it pretty. They just got to go out there and win. So I kind of want to go under on these passing props. And the last passing prop that I was looking at is Patrick Mahomes under 274. I don't think I'm crazy for thinking this, because there's no way that his ankle is 100% now. There's no way. The way that thing got twisted up, I feel like he dislocated something or tore a ligament. There's some damage in there that they're not disclosing, and they won't disclose until probably well after the season, when you find out that he had off-season surgery. But he could not step into his throws last week. He was hopping around on one leg. That is not the Patrick Mahomes that is going to pass for 275 yards. That's not even the Patrick Mahomes that's going to pass for 200 yards. So I like the under on that one too. Just trying to figure out the best way to go when pairing up with this Joe Burrow free square and looking at the passing yards. Those are the ones that stick out to me the most. The rushing yards, receiving yards, receptions, I've looked into these. I didn't really see anything that stood out that I really liked, to be honest with you. So as of now, I would probably play this prop a couple of different ways. I'd go Joe Burrow under, pair it up with Brock Purdy under, and then another slip and go Joe Burrow under and pair it up with Patrick Mahomes under, and you know, put $10 on each two man, or if you felt more confident in Purdy over Mahomes or Mahomes over Purdy, just put your whole, you know, $20-$25 on that one power play and win yourself $75 come Sunday night. So there you have it. That is all I have for this really, really quick video. Leave me a comment below letting me know who you're pairing up with the Joe Burrow free square. Also, let me know what you think about my looks into these passing props, the unders. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know in the comments below. Like to hear what's on your mind. Thank you once again for stopping by the channel, chilling out with me for a few minutes. And until my next Prize Picks video, Chavez is out.